Welcome to another video. It's another ironing video, and today I have several pants, shirts, dresses to iron. So first I set up my ironing board. And while the iron is warming up, I am making sure that the pant leg is nice and straight. And then using my iron along the center and to the sides, but not necessarily touching or ironing the seams. These pants are very easy to iron just because they are pretty much 100% cotton. Now the second leg, again, I am going to straighten it out, making sure no wrinkles are on top or the bottom, feeling the fabric from underneath. Just like that. Really making sure it's ready. And now, using my iron to smooth out the center of the pant leg. Again, not touching the seams. These pants don't even need to be turned off. So I switch to the back of the pant, just ironing out any wrinkles that I see. And then the other side, making sure that the pocket is straight. Going over the fabric with my iron. Now I'm just going to do the pant legs, the creases. So I align the seams perfectly, and just shake the pants and then put them on the ironing board again, straightening them out both legs, and just like that. And repeating the same thing I did for each pant leg, feeling for any wrinkles, setting everything up nice and straight, and going over the edges to create that perfect straight crease. I have to re-angle the pants a little bit so that I get to the center that is typically slightly angled. hopefully burn myself, as I always do. And just the back of the pants. Really straightening them out to make sure they're nicely aligned. Just like that. And then rolling over. I don't typically roll over to the end. And now the front. Again, correcting anything that's out of line. And darning over with my iron. The steam will make it nice and straight. Great. Gonna place the pants on my bed for now. And then I will hang them. In just the little area that got wrinkled from the steam that I want to iron out before I finish with the pants. Just a little bit right here. There we go. That looks great now. Alright. Going to place the pants on the bed while I'm getting another pair. And here I have a straight cut pants where the legs are pretty much straight. And these are wide legs. I like wide leg pants just because I don't really like when the pants are overly tight. I kind of feel like I need some space to move around and kind of let myself loose, I guess. So I go over the pant leg again in a typical manner. One other thing that I didn't use or use this pair as a protector that goes between the iron and the pants. I just couldn't find it. It's a sort of a mesh cotton layer so that the pants, especially not the seams, don't get that shine. Couldn't find it that time, and I didn't want to look. And it's hard to get rid of that glossy, shiny type of visual on pants, and you see them all the time if you look at somebody's pants really close, which is kind of weird, but you know. Alright, and now I'm aligning the pants as I did before. Well, to create that straight line. And just like that, making sure the top is also aligned. Really feeling the fabric for any wrinkles underneath. There we go. And now going over to make that straight line. But as you see, I try not to touch the seams. To just readjust a bit to straighten the edges, and now I'm slowly rolling the edges to create that line. just a little bit so that the line is straight, and ironing it again, just like that. And now, these pants are also done. Next pair is a complicated pair. It has a lining. A very, very worn pair that has lining, but when I bought this pair, it really wasn't that bad. So what I like to do is to take the lining out, make sure it doesn't fall, that the pants don't fall, and they will. And then just iron the lining separately from pants, because when you keep the lining in, it's very difficult to iron both the lining and the pants without any wrinkles. And when you wear these pants, the lining, if it's wrinkled, shows up as a wrinkled when you sit down. So it doesn't look very good. So I go over this fabric, which is very light, thin, with my iron to get rid of any visible wrinkles. Just one area that really didn't feel right, so I wanted to make sure ironed out. So it's basically just spot checking and ironing as you go along. And the fabric is really thin, and that's typical lining. It takes some time to get rid of all the wrinkles and not create more. Have to be very careful with that. Now we're gonna get to the main part. Pant legs. And this is a pretty easy part. They're also made of cotton, primarily. Pretty thick material. Straightening it out a bit and going over with my iron. Getting rid of all the wrinkles. The iron is nice and hot. Steam flows. Next, just going over some areas that didn't get ironed, and then these pants, I can actually go over the seams, just because they are made of cotton, and there's very little synthetic material that can melt. Next leg. Again, really straightening it out, just like that, and going over with my iron, nice and slow to avoid any wrinkles. Make sure that none are created. Flip it over. Straighten it out. even on this one, I am trying to get rid of the seam wrinkles that just weren't going and get in the way. Not very successful, but we'll see what happens. It just doesn't feel exactly right. That's okay. Let's try how it's gonna iron out. I'm going on the edges. It looks pretty good actually. I'm gonna be adjusting as I go along. Make sure no additional wrinkles are created. Just like that. And now I'm going to put the lining back here. Just, it's quite easy. The lining together with the lining, holding it together. Looking here, probably have nice materials. Now I'm just gonna do the back. To the other side and ironing them the other way as well. Alright, I'm just doing the front pockets as well. Lining the pocket and going over with my iron. Along the edges of the pocket. Switching to the other side. And going over with my hair. Perfect. Alright. These pants don't really require that straight line because they're just worn as the regular pants. But I do like to line them regardless so that I hang them nicely. And then I'll put them back on the bed. Next. Another pair of pants. This color is it looks like brown, but it's more maroonish. I have to be very careful with these pants just because they are synthetic. So I quickly go over to avoid any kind of damage. Alright, and just do the other way. The goal here is to get rid of that straight line so that when I iron it again, the new line is fresh. Okay. This looks good. just going to align the seams like that. Shake the pants just a bit. And place them on the board. Again, I am going to trim the legs out, align the edges, align the seams to create that straight line. There is a little bit more of a curve to these pants, so I'm going to readjust as I go along. Again, this here, I am not touching the seams, just the edges. And making sure that the line is straight. Just like that. And the other side. Switching to the front. And creating that straight line in the front. This looks good. Alright. Next item that I have to wear is this shirt. This is a shirt that I typically wear with a suit. It's 100% cotton. Wrinkles easily, but it's also easy to wear. Just realigning it. This shirt is quite tight. Also inspect it for any stains that were left over or anything, any damage from the wash. Straightening it out again. And I'm just going over with my iron a few times. It doesn't take much for me to sign sure to really be well ironed, so it's quite easy. Do it again, just like that. And I'm just getting to this side, the smaller type, smaller bay areas that could also be visible. And just using the shoulders on the shirt. Pretty tight, so and that's it for this shirt. Next item is this dress. It's relatively easy to wear and because it's primarily made from synthetic material. I roll it gently and don't stop in one spot for a time to avoid the materials and the fabric to melt with heat. And as you can see, I'm running from the inside so that those areas would show up as ironed areas. Don't have those lines. Next, I'm just gonna do the color, the neck. It kind of folds over 3 times to create this like large hanging U shape neck. Looks pretty good, but it doesn't feel like I want it. Next dress is this older dress. And I'm starting here, ironing it on the outside. It's also primarily cotton, but I don't want to show any of those lines, so I just switched it over to iron it from the inside out. You can see from the video here that just some areas tend to show those lines more than others. Moving the dress around to make sure all the areas are captured during the ironing process. And roll over it again. Gently, not to linger too much. Don't start burning the fabric. Getting into the intricacies of the cut. This dress is not the easiest to iron, but it looks pretty good when you wear it. Those folds are all nicely. I typically would even take the dress out of the dryer before it's fully dry and then hang it to avoid any ironing whatsoever. Now, just going to do the front by stretching the neck a bit and going over. Not that. It's more of a detail pattern than anything. Again, stretching it over the ironing board and shifting it to the shoulder area. Just like that. On the other side, similar now. Good. And I'm just going over this area one more time. And just even need a little bit of not a burn, but area that might have had the iron for too long. Next, we have this shirt. It's a formal type of shirt. Long sleeve. Very nice fabric. I'm going to wear it material cut. And the fabric is a little bit thick. It just feels very nice on skin. Going over the other side of the front part of the shirt. Avoiding any area that could get easily wrinkled with iron. Top of the ironing process is to avoid making any wrinkles. You see the side, that's how it's made. And then switching to the back. And doing one section at a time. Going over the center section. And then moving the shirt to the other side. And ironing the other side of the back. I'm just taking care of the shoulder and the back. And the collar as well. And getting to the shoulder area. Like that. Now the other shoulder. Lining it up and going over with my iron. Now just doing the sleeves, the last part. Straightening out the sleeve and just kind of following the same procedure as with the pants. Feeling for any wrinkles. And going over with my iron. Very good, and then again, now we go back to the last part of the shirt, the second sleeve, straightening it out, aligning the seams, only one seam really, but making sure everything is nice and straight, and then going over with my iron. And this one looks like the lead needs to be on just a little bit more. Looks great. Hope you enjoy this. Goodbye.